Jesus, your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord of Mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, your Word made flesh in splendor of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. God, Father of mercies, whose only begotten Son, as he hung upon the cross, chose the Blessed Virgin Mary, his mother, to be our mother also. Grant, we pray that with her loving help, your church may be more fruitful day by day, and exalting in the holiness of her children, may draw to her grace all the families of the kingdom. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the kingdom of the Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Such a thing? The woman answered, "The serpent tricked me into it, so I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you shall be banned from all the animals and from all the wild creatures. On your belly you shall crawl, and dirt shall you eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike at your head, while you strike at his heel." The man called his wife Eve, because she became the mother of all the living. The word of the Lord. All you nations, praise the Lord.
All you nations, praise the Lord.
His foundation upon the holy mountain, the Lord loves. The gates of Zion, more than any dwelling of Jacob. Glorious things are said of you, O city of God. All you nations, praise the Lord. I tell of Egypt and Babylon, among those who know the Lord, the Philistine. Tyre, Ethiopia. This man was born there, and of Zion they shall say, "One and all were born in her, and he who has established her is the Most High Lord." All the nations praise the Lord. They shall note when the peoples are enrolled, "This man was born there," and all shall sing in their festive dance, "My home is within you."
All the nations praise the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Says the Lord, who
whoever follows me will have eternal life. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple there whom he loved, he said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his home. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Southfield be guinea pigs. It's great to be able to gather everyone together, albeit in a rather strange way, but baby steps, we're getting there. Hopefully this won't have to take too long doing this kind of setup every day, and we'll be back in the church in no time, hopefully. But in the meantime, such as it is, it's just good to see everyone again. There's a meme that went viral a few years ago on Catholic memes. It's a picture of an old medieval depiction of Mary grabbing Satan by the collar or the neck or whatever, and then socking him in the eye. The caption reads, "Hail Mary, full of grace, punch the devil in the face." It may be a little bit irreverent, but it's still a great depiction of one of the two major roles that Mary filled and one of the two major parts to this feast that we celebrate today of Mary, Mother of the Church. Because anyone who either is a mother or has a good relationship with their mother knows you don't mess with the mom. You don't come between mom and the kids. Mary, as our mother, it was entrusted to us for our protection and also her intercession and her help in our day-to-day lives. So whenever we're struggling with temptation, whenever we're struggling with great crisis, we can turn to her and ask for her help, and she will swoop in, the loving mother as she is, and come to our aid, come to our defense. There is no figure in the church apart from God himself who the devil fears more than Mary because of her humility, her virtue, her purity, etc. Mary is God's greatest weapon in the church and the church's greatest defender in her day-to-day life. But not only is she our defender, she's also our intercessor. No one in the church's history has greater intercessory power than Mary. Whenever we turn to her and ask for her intercession, we're not worshiping her, we're not praising her or anything like that in the sense that we would with God, but we're entrusting our prayers to her because no one has Jesus' ear more than Mary does. Louis de Montfort, the great Marian saint who wrote True Devotion to Mary, described her intercession as basically akin to that of the mother of the king back in olden days. Her role would be basically if we were to come, the lowly peasant that we are, were to come to give a gift to God, say just a simple apple. We know our gift is really not that remarkable. There's not much to it. We can have a beautiful polished apple, but at the end of the day, it's just an apple. So we know that it's not really much on its own to present to God. So rather than taking it directly to God, who is the king, we go to the mother to ask for her help in making the apple more presentable. And she, in her love and compassion for us, takes the apple and puts on the beautiful golden platter, and then takes it and presents it to God for us. So that is the role that she fulfills. Not just simply asking someone on our behalf, but she transforms our prayers to be more suitable, more beautiful in their presentation to God. So as we turn to celebrate our duty today in this unique role as Mother of the Church, trust both in her protective and her intercessory prayer. our need is today, whether it's our deliverance from this plague, whether it's our own particular needs, maybe we're struggling with an ailment or injury, maybe there's some rupture in our families, turn to Mary and ask for her help and her intercession to overcome whatever obstacles exist in touch. Praise be Jesus Christ, now and acknowledging our neediness, we turn to God and offer Him our prayers.
For Pope Francis, all bishops, priests, and deacons, may the Spirit draw them together to devote themselves with one accord to prayer. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For officials, may God give them eyes of mercy and hearts of truth. Common good, and care for those they serve. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Especially expecting mothers facing uncertainty and poverty, may God give them the grace they need to lovingly welcome their children into the world as Mary did. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For this community gathered here in worship, may the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary help us to grow in grace, fortitude, and fear of the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And for an end to the violence throughout our cities in the U.S., that people may resolve their differences in peace, trusting in the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who have died, may all the angels soon welcome them into the heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Now in silence, please take a moment and offer your own petitions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, we ask that you hear and answer the prayers we make with one accord. We pray all these things through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Similar way when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and
maintain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Louis de Montfort, and with all the saints, on his constant intercession in your presence, we rely from failing help. May this sacrifice of reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Ronald, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you've summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passage from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, who will be bestowed on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Agnus Domini, qui tollis peccatam mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Domini, qui tollis peccatam mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Domini, qui tollis peccatam mundi. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
A wedding was held in Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Then Jesus performed the first of his signs, manifested his glory, and his disciples believed in him. Let us say the prayer of spiritual communion for those unable to have attended this Holy Mass and are joining us through the live stream. Lord Jesus Christ, I truly believe that you are really present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I adore you with profound love. And although I cannot receive you at this moment sacramentally, come into my heart and soul spiritually. And as if you were already there, Lord, I pray that you will never let me be separated from you.
Let us pray. Having received your pledge of redemption and of life, we humbly pray, O Lord, that with the Blessed Virgin's motherly help, your Church may teach all nations by proclaiming the gospel, and through the grace of the outpouring of the Spirit fill the whole earth through Christ our Lord. So just a quick explanation as to how this is going to work for the reception of the communion. For a reception of Holy Communion, we will conclude Mass. Father, myself, and the deacon will go back into the hall, and I'll take my chasuble off. I'll bring the scoria back out here, and I'll stand at the bottom of these steps to my right. Those of you who wish to receive Holy Communion, our lovely traffic guards will direct you to the proper position to pull up. You'll exit the vehicle. There's our traffic guard over there. All those who wish to communicate can get out of the car, receive communion, jump back in the car, and then be on your way. And we'll just keep repeating that until everyone who wishes to receive has received. Those of you who do not wish to receive communion, be directed, I guess, another route out. I haven't actually been consulted as to the full details here, so. Renee, we'll just direct them out for those who don't wish to receive. Renee? Yes? No? Okay, we'll just direct you out for those who... For for those who don't wish to receive it, you can just pull on out, all right? So please be patient. This is still a learning process for all of us. We're going to try to make this as smooth as possible, all right? And thank you for your patience in advance. Please keep us in our prayers as we learn this now with a small congregation, so that when we get the big congregation over the weekend, we can do this as smoothly as possible. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.